Excellent choice. This is a tale of blood and sadness, when vicious Mongols hunted every twin on Tsushima and captured their spirits. The island prayed for warriors to save the twins, and the ghosts answered the call. They tracked the captive twins to a Mongol roadblock. Ghosts tracked the prisoner's trail through the camp, but the captive twins were nowhere to be found. Cart tracks, cut deep in the ground, provided the only sign of where they went. The ghosts followed the trail. Mongol's eyes burned with dark flame, a sign of their dreadful bond. The enemy fell, but he was soon revived by the spirit of his tethered twin. Cursed Mongols fell, their link shattered. The ghosts found the carts, but not the twins. Only wheel tracks remained, leading deeper into the forest. The ghosts followed, determined to rescue the twins of Tsushima. A Mongol cart traveled up the road, escorted by foes protecting mysterious cargo.
Yeah.
With their enemies slain, the ghosts were free to search the cart. Inside, they made a grisly discovery. Human hearts, freshly harvested from the twins of Tsushima. They struck out, following the cart's direction. By reaping the hearts of Tsushima's twins, the Oni were able to tether themselves to each other, sharing a life force that could not be broken. So long as one of them remained alive, the ghosts arrived at a war camp to confront its gruesome leaders.
you.
Another story for another time. Listen while I recount an adventure of the ghosts. Which of these legends interest you? I'll share any story with you. Let's begin. This is the tale of Io, an Onibaba who gave birth to an inhuman army, imbuing them with an unnatural strength and a wicked hate that rivaled her own. The ghosts set out to stop Io before her army became invincible. The cursed soldiers were empowered by Io's rage, her vengeful spirit. As long as she remained, they could not fall. Servant.
The ghost, bring them to me.
Seek vengeance, but we will stronger together.
Ritual sacrifice and bloodshed, harnessing pain and anguish. The disciples of Io were able to power her army. As long as the disciples remained, her soul...
Tsushima is part of me now. Ever since that day, sacrifices. Humans always have to sacrifice.
You only destroy disciples, not me.
The ghosts knew their only hope of stopping Io was to save the other monks before she could consume their spirit.
I was a woman once, long ago, but that was before that day, that horrible day.
As the ghost drew near to a mysterious village, they discovered a terrible sight. Honorable spirits held prisoner, used as stores from which Io fed. Prisoners to escape.
Does one drop in a pond make a difference?
As the ghosts drew near to a mysterious village, they discovered a terrible sight. Honorable spirits held prisoner, used as stores from which Io fed. The prisoners could not be freed until it was safe. Eo's prisoners would be killed unless her army was defeated. Although the ghosts freed the body, the spirit was no longer there. The disciples dispersed, the prisoners freed. This army defeated. Eo grew eerily silent. But had she been defeated? Or had she simply moved on to somewhere else? Deeds of the ghosts are many. Let me share one with you. Which of these legends interests you? One of my favorites. This is a tale of dark rituals and powerful spirits. The Mongols wished to make themselves great and used these rituals to steal ki from three elemental kami. Amaterasu, goddess of the sun. Tsukuyomi, god of the moon. And Susanoo, god of storms. The rituals were draining the kami of their ki, so the ghosts set out to save them. At a conquered village, the Mongols had opened their door to the spirit realm to steal ki from the kami. The ghosts resolved to destroy the ritual. Ended. The door between realms closed, but new rituals had already begun elsewhere. The ghost set out in search of these other threats. Found three more rituals, one beside a river, one at a war camp, and one within the canyon. But the Mongols had almost completely drained the kami. The ghost would need extraordinary strength to defeat them. Mm-mm. Ended the ritual, but their fight was far from over. Another ritual was stopped, and another door closed, but the ghost's work was not yet done.
We should not seek vengeance, but we will.
The final ritual had been stopped, and the ghosts breathed a sigh of relief. But the kami whispered to the ghosts that an even greater threat still remained. The darkest Mongol ritual was under the care of the great Onibaba, Iyo.
Kami are honorable. They are not. In my darkest hour, I pray to them. But my prayers fell on deaf ears. And an innocent life was lost. I am only taking what they owe me. Do not stand in my way.
Iyo's ritual was surrounded by Mongol guardians. The ghosts had to defeat them all. Iyo's ritual was nearly complete. The Onibaba moments away from victory. Enraged, Onibaba sent the Oni slaughter the ghosts. were slain, the rituals ended. The Oni Baba would not realize her plans. The ghosts were triumphant, and the Kami were free. Balance had returned to the island. All was safe for now. I have many legends for you to enjoy. Choose, and I'll tell it. Let's begin. This is the tale of Uchitsune, an archer whose skill rivaled the power of Iyo, the great Onibamba. Fearful, she trapped him in a cursed place, enslaving and torturing him with the misdeeds of his past. The ghosts set out to free the warrior from Iyo's grasp. The ghost cautiously approached the bow. The fearsome spirit of an ancient samurai appeared.
Welcome, samurai. My name is Ujitsune, Iyo, the powerful Onibaba, trapped me in this realm. Long ago, my bow was blessed by a kami. If anything can break Iyo's hold on this place, it's the bow. The Onibaba's followers approach. Quick, use my bow to defeat them. Yoshi Springs. Follow me. We must end the Onibaba's curse.
Uchitsune led the ghosts to Yoshi Springs. Uchitsune was an archer of legend, known for saving an entire kingdom from a fearsome demon known as Gotengu.
That is why Iyo trapped me. She has been feeding off my spirit in order to...
The town of Hiyoshi Springs was overrun with invaders seeking Iyo's power.
Wield my bow once more to rid the area of Iyo's presence.
Thank you.
Many ghosts freed the village, but more cursed Mongols swarmed the hill.
The Onibaba's strength is fading. Free the rest of the town. Send the rest of them to the thousand hells.
We should not seek vengeance, but we will.
Disciples were gone. Yoshi Springs was quiet.
Come, there is one last thing we must do. When I killed the Kotengu, I was unaware of the curse it placed on me. I killed countless more, only to learn later that my eyes had deceived me. My arrows only pierced human flesh. This is what attracted Eo. I am to blame for all that has happened. Free me and free this place.
The Onibaba's servants arrived, determined to keep Uchitsune enslaved.
that firm, Kyoshi Springs will be free. Her curse is nearly broken.
Kyoshi Springs and Uchitsune of the terrible curse.
Ghosts, my spirit may be free, but I will not be reborn just yet. I must find new ways to stop the Onibabas.
Uchitsune found redemption and a new purpose, thanks to the ghosts. Which of these legends interest you? one of my favorites. Ah, yes, the crow demons of Ochena. When the Mongols and the demons conspired to take a village in Kubara, and a mysterious legend awaited the ghosts somewhere in the cavernous darkness. Our story begins with a fisherman in need.
Help! They took my friend! Please, hurry!
Below the ghosts stood a figure surrounded by crows. Its black eyes searched for prey, hungry.
There they are! The Tengu! Demons. Crow demons.
I've heard of you. They say, thank you. Thank you so much. I was in Otsuna village. There were thousands of crows. So many. The demons. Please, my boat. Take it. Save our village, please.
Thank you, my lord.
Wherever the Tengu go, crows surely follow, as do terrible things. Tengu are tricksters, manipulators. Some say they can even invade dreams and possess the mind and spirit. The ghosts arrived, only to find Otsuna village had been visited by death and destruction.
Mm.
My gratitude. The others, they took them across the river. I heard the demon speak, but it was a different tongue, an evil tongue. All I could understand was Oni Baba.
Thank you. Tengu. They ripped them apart.
Down from the old monastery and the cave. Beware the cave.
The ghost traveled toward the mountains, hoping they could stop the Tengu and find the cave that had terrified the villagers.
You are trying to stop what you do not know. The people are angry. The island is angry. Once the Tengu have taken their bodies, word will spread of my coming.
The monastery loomed over the trees in the distance. The ghost pressed on, searching for the source of the Tengu. The ghosts reached the cave and sensed great power inside, something unnatural, beyond just human. The tango defeated, the cave grew silent, and the ghosts found themselves before Kojiro.
The spirits once blessed me, but now Io has cursed me with something so much more.
Slain, Io no longer controlled the Tengu and was unable to rally the people to her cause. But the crows of Utsuna were only part of her plan. Listen while I recount an adventure of the ghosts. What legend would you like to hear? One of my favorites. This is a story of sacred relics, stolen for profane purposes. When the Mongols targeted divine artifacts, and how the ghosts rose to stand in their way. As the ghosts neared, they were met by a single monk.
Over here!
As the ghosts knew, a scout meant more Mongols were near. Another group of Mongols appeared, intent on killing the monk. A fearsome Oni suddenly charged at the ghosts. The demon's eyes were as red and fiery as its massive shield. Ghost ran to help. Rushed into the burning temple.
The guardian statue is missing. They couldn't have taken it far. There's another cart!
Though there were many stolen relics, the statue was nowhere to be found. The ghost continued searching below the temple. The ghosts discovered the rest of the caravan's guards.
here. But where were they taking it?
Along with this statue, the ghosts found a map with the path the Mongols were taking.
I know that area on the map. I'll show you the way.
Many believe temple statues hold great power, sometimes even containing the ghosts arrived at the first marked location on the map and planned their attack.
If the map is right, the Mongols will pass this way soon. Coming. Get ready.
Defeated Mongol and demon alike. But more enemies were on the horizon. Ghosts heard the rest of the caravan approaching. Thank you.
They had no carts with them. Perhaps the things they stole have already been taken ahead. We should find out where they were going.
Oni found many ways to travel between the heavenly realms. Some even convinced humans to release them from their prisons. The ghost reached the final location on the map in the Umugi swampland.
I dare not go any further. It's up to you now.
So, you've come to stop me. Kill them if you wish. They did their part. For centuries, I was trapped within the temple statue. Io has released me. She'll free the rest of my kind as well. And you will all feel our wrath.
Countless statues and relics littered the grounds, stolen from the temples. Oni met the ghosts in battle, eager to protect the stolen statues and relics, eager to protect Io's army.
to the shadows!
Defeated, Io's plan had failed. The statues and relics were returned to the temples and kept under watchful eye. For even today, some claim they feel the power of Oni pushing against their prisons, eager to enter our world once more. Listen while I recount an adventure of the ghosts.